Hey guys, Tom here from Digismoothie, and in this video I will explain how to use metafields and metaobjects in your Shopify store. Metafields and metaobjects are still quite a complex topic which many merchants do not fully comprehend. You can think about the metafield as a placeholder which can store value, and the value can be different per each product, for example. So it's great to store values like colors, material, measures, parameters and stuff like that, while the metaobject consists of multiple values. Now the problem with metafield is that it can only contain one type of values, while metaobject can consist of multiple values with different types, including metafields as well. So think about metafield as a simple place to store value, while metaobject is more robust space which can consist of multiple values and value types. On the product page here, we are using metafield, for example, to display the designer name. And we are using metaobject to display the designer info, including the image. Before using metafields and metaobjects, you need to define them. So you would probably expect you can find them in the content section, but for some reason there are only metaobjects. There are no metafields here. To create metafields, you need to go to settings, custom data, and here are the metafields. You can choose from different groups. Basically, these groups tell you where the metafield will be used. And here you can see the metafield called designer name, which consists of multiple values. And inside the product detail, I can select the designer name to any of the specified values. I can also add new values if needed. So we created a metafield, we loaded the data, and now we want to display it on our storefront. So I'm now on the product detail page, and here is an example with the designer. So you can connect any metafield by clicking on the dynamic source icon, and you will basically just select the meta field or meta objects you want to connect. So in our example again, we connected the designer name meta field, which is then displayed on the product pages. The reason why we are using meta field here is that the same designer can be shared throughout multiple products, and we don't want to type it every time. We want it to be dynamically loaded from the database of meta fields. Okay, so hopefully meta field was quite easy to understand. Now let's have a look into meta object. So I will go to content meta object, and I will select feature designer, which is the block designer on the product detail page. And I will show you how it's defined. So I will click on the designer, and you can see it contains multiple fields and multiple values. So for example, name, some description, picture, and even some colors. So now we have the meta object and we want to load it on the storefront. I clicked on the product block. And the difference is that you don't connect the every little item here. You need to connect the whole block by clicking the icon here. And you can see all the dynamic sources inside the product block have automatically connected to the meta object and loaded the values. To summarize it again, think about meta field as a simple custom value which you can display anywhere on your storefront, while meta object can contain multiple value and value types. And the reason why you should be using them is that it can save you a lot of time if you have some content which is repeated on multiple pages. Another advantages of using metafields and metaobjects are that they are very simple to localize. So if you are using Shopify markets, translating metafields and metaobjects is super simple using the Translate and Adapt app. And they can also be used as filters on the storefront. Thanks much for watching. Hope this was useful and easy to understand. If you have any questions about anything specific related to metafields or metaobjects, just comment below and we will be happy to help. Thank you and see you soon.